Welcome back to Beyond the Game with Hal, where we uncover the personal and professional triumphs of athletes on and off the field. I'm your host, Hal, a young aspiring sports broadcaster with a strong interest in stories that go deeper than statistics. Today, I'm excited to welcome Saboor Kareem, a standout cornerback from Illinois. Saboor has made a name for himself with his incredible agility, tactical intelligence, and unwavering dedication, both on and off the gridiron. Join us as Saboor shares his journey from his early days of football to becoming a Fighting Illini. Discuss the challenges that he's faced, the victories he celebrated, and his aspirations for the future. Get ready for an inspiring conversation that goes deeper than the character and the comment that it takes to excel in collegiate football.
What's good?
What's up, man, bro?
Hey, thank you for sitting down and doing this. Great. Finally happy we got to do this.
Yeah, let's get to it.
So to start off here is you came from New Jersey. What was your recruitment process to come from New Jersey to a school like Illinois?
I think Illinois was around my fourth or fifth offer. I had never been to the Midwest before, so it was kind of like everything was new to me. But once I actually came here on my unofficial visit, like the moment I walked in the door, I knew I was going to commit, and I wanted to commit. And crazy enough, I actually didn't commit on my OV. I didn't commit until like a couple weeks before signing day. But I had told Coach B that I was going to come here after my OV.
You said your first time like visiting the Midwest. I mean, the weather's not really a big factor from Jersey, but was there like just a feeling in the air, or did you really like the coaching staff? Was there any particular thing that you really liked?
Yeah, the people that's here, the coaching staff that's here. You know, it's changed a little bit, but I felt like the culture of family is still big in the building, and that's really why I'm here.
All right. And then another thing with, obviously you're going into your sophomore, you just completed spring ball, right? Are you finished with that now?
Yes, sir.
How was that now taking like a jump from your freshman to sophomore year? And what's the difference between like spring ball, your freshman and your sophomore year?
Yeah, this is my first spring ball. I didn't early enroll last year. So after the season last year and then coming into spring ball, you know, I got a lot more reps. And you get the feel of college, you know, what it's like to actually play. And so it was kind of a great learning experience before summer workouts and then before fall camp.
I mean, you got some action last year, but obviously this year, are you expecting to take a jump in that and take more of a bigger role on that team?
Yes, sir. That's the goal.
Yeah. Another thing with the new Big Ten, it's more traveling. Have you guys really talked about that any a little bit, or is that going to play a factor into your travel at all and the way you guys prepare?
Oregon, you know, coming to the Big Ten, we go there this year. So it'll be definitely something we talk about, how we're going to prepare, you know, stay fresh on our legs, you know, don't let the flight take too much of our energy on the way over there. But right now, you know, so far away from the season, it hasn't been too much talk about the travel aspect of it all.
And you played both multiple sports in high school. Mm-hmm. What do you think the impact of that is to play multiple sports?
Not only do you meet different type of people, you know, you kind of just you get a lot of different skill sets. Like dribbling the basketball and carrying a football are two different things, but they're both required for, you know, their respective sports. And then I played lacrosse in high school too, and I felt like it just took my hand-eye coordination to a whole nother level. And that helped, that translated over, you know, to football and a bunch of other things in my life.
Yeah, and having those bonds with your teammates, obviously you said earlier family is a big thing at Illinois. What does it mean to you to be part of that family and, like, buy into that culture?
It's everything, you know. You spend a lot of time around these people. Sometimes it can, at other programs, you can see how there can become divides in the locker room just based off, you know, cultural backgrounds, you know, just a bunch of different things. And I feel like here, we don't really, even our locker room is set up that everybody knows everybody. We don't sit by a position. It's just randomly placed. And so my locker mate is Hugh Roberts and Magnus Moeller. Magnus is from, I think, I want to say, I can't remember. I want to say Sweden, but I can't remember. And Hugh was from Australia. and Hugh's 31, and Magnus is a grade older than me. So it's like everybody just knows everybody. You get to meet different people. You hear different stories. And I think that's why we're so close, is because nobody is left out.
I mean, whether it's the quarterback, cornerback, or kicker, they all play a role in the team.
Yes, sir.
And I mean, having bonds with all those, being on the same page, there's nothing better than that that could help you guys win the football game.
No doubt.
So you saying being a cornerback, has there been any like special bonds between the position, or is it more just like a team effort?
In the corner, in the room, in our
defensive
back room, has there been a special bond?
Yeah.
Definitely. You know, we out there together, you gotta communicate. You know, you work as a unit, you know. You can't do anything by on your own out there. So there's definitely been a special bond made. You know, a lot of guys are getting older too, so they're becoming more vets in the program. So, you know, just learning, being a sponge, because you don't know everything. And, you know, they're only there to help. So there's definitely been special bonds made in our defensive back room.
What does it mean to you? You obviously have to be a leader to get to college. What does it mean to you to be a leader within high school? And then even being a leader, even if you're not a captain, being a leader and leading by example?
I feel like that's a really good question. I feel like in high school, because everybody's not at such a high skill level, you're almost, you got to pull your team along, if that makes sense. It's like you got to push everybody to be their best. And in college, everybody's really good. So the leadership is almost doing the right thing. Being like Coach B always talk about, tough, smart, dependable. Doing the right thing, that's you. That's leadership qualities. If you just do the right thing, because naturally people will follow. Like, it'll just become routine. Like, if you just do your job every day, so the man next to you gonna start doing his job every day, and the man next to him gonna start doing his job every day. So it just trickles over. I feel like, especially with me still being young, just guys in the locker room that's, you know, in their sixth, seventh year, and they, you know, older guys, you know, seniors, and we got a lot of juniors. So it's like there's definitely hierarchy in those ways, but still there's still room to be a leader. Even in my position room, you know, on the field, on the field with my defense. But it's like, you know, just doing your job, doing what you're supposed to do. That's the biggest difference, instead of, you know, worrying about the next man. Because in college, you got to just, doing your job is the best thing you can do for the team.
Right, because if people see that other people are not doing their job, they're going to be like, oh, I don't have to do it either. But they see five guys are doing it, and then they're like, they're going to do it, then maybe another guy's going to do it, and it's just a chain reaction there. Right. And you also said that there's a lot of junior seniors. What have those people as leaders meant to you?
Well, especially the guys that was here when I was a freshman last year during the season, Johnny, Isaiah, all the guys that, you know, in the draft now, you see in the pro and bowls, stuff like that. Those guys, you know, they kind of more so raised me in the grand scheme of college sports. Like, you know, just when you come from high school, especially I came so late, I was the last enrollee. It was like you just don't understand what's going on yet, you know. But they kind of just explained it to me and broke it down. And now that some of the guys was on the team last year are, you know, a year older, it's like they understand, you know, and they see potential in me, and they just push me every day to be the best me. So I think that's the difference between the best that I had last year and the best that I got now.
Yeah, and you were saying between the high school and college, last and really, it's a completely different game.
Definitely, definitely.
I have Final 14, doing this with everyone. So let's get into it. All right.
Final 14?
Yeah, they're like more rapid-fire paced questions.
Oh, okay.
All right. What's your biggest fear?
Breaking a bone.
Favorite school subject?
Math.
Favorite hobby other than football?
Video games.
Favorite YouTuber?
360 Jeezy.
Favorite gym workout?
Push day.
Favorite artist? Musician.
Kodak.
Favorite animal?
A dog.
Biggest pet peeve?
Wet socks.
What's your favorite TV show?
Phineas and Ferb.
Is a hot dog a sandwich?
Is it? It's one piece of bread, right?
Yeah.
No, it's not sandwich day.
Are you a shower singer?
Yeah.
And then what's your favorite emoji to throw in text?
Probably just the laughing emoji with the two tears.
Yeah, that's a popular one. All right. Thank you once again.
All right. See you later, buddy.
See ya. Like a drum, baby, don't stop beating. Like a drum, baby, don't stop beating. Like a drum, my heart never stops beating.